Did you know that you can install anything you want on your Proxmox server using just one command? Let me show you how it's done. And what you need to Google is Proxmox helper scripts. Then we can click that very top link from the GitHub pages. And then we can either choose one tool from a given category, and you will see it's quite a few of them. Let's say media photo. You have all nice stuff like Plex Media Server or Jellyfin or Sonar. It's just one category, remember? For operating system, you've got the newest Ubuntu available, 24.04. All of that can be installed using just one command. But I think the easiest way is to simply go up and here in this search window, you can just search for whatever you're interested in. So maybe Casa OS, it's a very interesting project that can also, as everything else, can be installed on Proxmox using just one command. And it's this command here. So let me copy it. We just then go to our Proxmox, to our node, in my case it's PVE, it's called PVE, and I just paste it here, that's it. Let's click Enter. It will ask us if we want to proceed, yes of course. And you've got option to use default settings or advanced settings. So I will use default. As we can see, the container was created on the left, container number 100. Now it is being updated, and we just have to wait. It takes a while, it's installing some dependencies, etc. Even says patience. But anyway, we can see Casa operating system is being installed. That's now done, and you can see Casa OS setup should be reachable by going to following URL. We just copy this URL, we paste it in our browser, and believe me or not, this is our operating system. All ready for us. You can just go, create a username, create a password. I will save it as well. And that's it. That's our Casa OS up and running. It can't really be easier than that. But bear in mind, not all links will complete the installation. Let me show you what I mean. Let's check that it was Ubuntu, the newest Ubuntu. And it's not the container I'm interested in, I'm interested in the VM, and this is the newest Ubuntu that actually is available. It was just recently released. And you can see we can also copy this command. It will also install everything in one go, like using just that one command. But have a look, more info at blah blah blah. What it is for? Let's have a look. First I copy this command, I go back to my Proxmox, to the node PVE in my case, to the shell, and I will paste it here. Just let me maybe clear it first. So yes, exactly the same process as we did with Casa OS. Now I just press enter and I just wait. Ubuntu is being installed. Proceed yes. Again, just default settings, so everything is done for me automatically. After a while, a new VM should be shown here, probably with the ID of 101. Oh, there it is. Virtual machine ID is 101. As we can see, it's being created here on the left. And that's it. But notice that this time it didn't give us the link to the operating system. We can't access it immediately. So it's been installed, but it says set up cloud init before starting. And it gives us actually a link to, believe it's the same 2072. Let's have a look. Yes, it's exactly the same link as here. So we either copy from there or we just click this one. And what it is, it tells us what to do, setting up cloud init. You don't have to know what cloud init is. It tells you exactly what has to be done. For example, you have to set up the root user, you have to create password for that, change the upgrade packages, etc. You simply have to follow these instructions to complete this process. This Ubuntu is already here, it's installed, but it's not fully configured. So bear that in mind. But it's still extremely streamlined operation. Like, you know, everything is done still in one command. You just have to configure some basic things. And the last thing I wanted to show you is if you don't really know, sometimes, especially more advanced users, they don't want to just run command and they don't even know what's going on in the background. Well, you can see these are links to the GitHub. So if you go back up to the very top, you've got that icon here, view on GitHub. What you can view there is actually the source code. So if you go to that install folder, you will see all of those shell scripts that run in the background. Like, for example, we installed that Casa OS, yes? So we can find that shell script, it will be this one, and you can see exactly step by step what is being done here. And this script is very short actually, but if we go to probably Debian will be home, that's not that long as well. I'm sure there will be much longer ones. Like, let's have a look at Grafana. A little bit longer. But my point is, this is simply the like open source project. You can check every single command and you can check line by line what is being done, what is being installed, etc. So it's like full transparency. And we can see also the author, TTEC. It's T-T-E-C-K. And I'm very grateful because, you know, that helps me a lot. So yes, that's all I wanted to say. I hope that helps and thank you for watching.